Hello students, welcome back once again to our class. Today we'll be studying about factorization by grouping. So I'll give you one example here. M square plus 5m plus mn plus 5n. So this is the given algebraic expression, this is the given polynomial. So what we find after observation is that from all the four terms, we do not have any common factor. Okay, forget about one. So in this kind of situation, what we are going to do is, we are going to make the groups consisting of the terms. So after making the groups, we'll be finding the common factor, and then we'll perform the factorization. So let me repeat. There are different situations where we cannot take the common factor from all the terms, so and we are compelled to do the factorization. So by how? By making the groups, and after making the groups, from each group we are trying to extract, we are trying to get, we are trying to find the common factor, then only we'll do our factorization. So let's begin. Let us see some questions. This is from exercise 7.3, question A. This is m square plus 5m plus mn plus 5n. Okay, we have here four terms, and when we see in this, look into this question, there is no common factor for all the terms. There is no common factor for all the terms. So in this situation, what we are going to do is, we are going to make the groups. Okay, let's see how we are going to make the groups. If I make the first two terms as a group and the last two terms in another group, so what shall we get? Let us just see once. This is m square plus 5m. So from these two, if I take common, then I'll be able to take common here as m, then we'll get here m plus 5. Okay, so from the last two terms, I'll be writing here mn plus 5n. So from these two terms, I can take n common, then here it will be m plus 5. Okay, now what we observe is, after making the groups, we have taken the common factor, then after that again, I find here some common factor here, that is m plus 5 and m plus 5. Okay, let me start. So from the first two terms, I will take m common. So here is m, so that out of 2, this power 2, and I have just taken here m to the power 1, so we have still m to the power 1, plus here will be 5 plus. From these two, I will take this n common, so n will be written here, so that m plus 5. So the next step will be, from this part and this part, m plus 5 whole is common, so we'll be taking here m plus 5, and remaining will be m plus n, so m plus n. Now we have performed our factorization, so we'll be moving to the next question, that is question B. Minus AC plus BD plus BC minus AD. Even here we have four terms, and I do not find any common factor for all the terms. Let me repeat, I do not get any common factor for all the terms. So now, because of that, we are going to start making the groups. Let's see. Let us look at the first two terms. From the first two terms, I do not find any common factor. So now, let me make in the another way. First and the last, third. Let me repeat, let me make a group consisting of the first term and the third term. So from the first and the third term, we find c common here. Okay, let me just write here minus ac plus bc. It is just the beginning, that's why let me speak slowly. Let me give you the details. Let me give you the full explanation. So from these two terms, I find here c common. So c here, then minus a plus b. And from second and the last, this is bd minus ad. So what we get here is d is common to both the terms. So I'll write here d, then here b minus a. This is minus a plus b, and this is b minus a. There is no difference actually. Minus a plus b means you can write b minus a. I just accent the position. This plus b I have written at the first, and minus a later. So there is no difference. So that we are getting one common factor here. What is that? That is b minus a whole as a common factor. So this minus ac, then plus bc. Now first and the third, remaining will be second and the last. So here bd minus ad. Okay, so from these two terms, let me take c common here. So remaining will be minus a plus b. Then from the last two, I can take here d common, so that I'll be getting here b minus a. Okay, so just to make you very clear, let me write in this way. B let me write first, and minus a later. So now I get here b minus a. So plus here d, then here b minus a whole. So from this part and this part, we see here b minus a common. So now let us take common here b minus a, then remaining will be c plus d. That's how we have performed the factorization. Okay, we'll be moving to the next question. I'll just pick question D. A square b plus c square minus ab minus ac square. Okay, so now we have even here four terms. The first term and the second term, there is no common factor except one. Okay, so again, the first and the third, this is a square b, and this is minus ab. So from here I can take ab common. If it happens to take, then a also I'll take, and b also I'll take. Here the power of a is 2, and this is 1. Out of 2, 1 is here. That means we have still one more. So 1 plus 1, it's 2. Now b here, it's already here, so I won't write anymore. A, see, 1, it's here. B to the power 1, again here. So we are going to write here 1. How 1 this is actually, I'll tell you. When we write here ab, this is nothing but, you can assume this is 1 into ab. So we are getting here ab. So nothing wrong. There will be 1 actually. So that 1 is here. So now a minus 1. And again, from second and the last, we'll be getting here c square minus ac square. Okay. So from these two terms, we can take here c square common, so that we'll get here 1 minus a. This is a minus 1, and this is 1 minus a. So how we are going to do? This is a minus 1 and 1 minus a. Let me express in this way. 1 minus a means, you can write in this way, you take minus common. Once you take minus common, then you have to write opposite sign of the terms. So this is positive, now you write negative here. Now this is negative, then you write positive. So minus, then a minus 1. This a I have written first and minus 1 later. That's how we get here a minus 1 and again a minus 1. Okay, let's begin now. So here a square b minus ab, then we have c square minus ac square. So from the first two terms we'll take ab common, so the remaining will be a minus 1. So that even from here we'll take c square common, then we get 1 minus a whole. Okay, from these two terms, from the first one I get here a minus 1, and from the second one I get here 1 minus a. So what should we do now? AB, then here a minus 1, so plus c square. In place of these, please remember, how did I write? Minus of here minus 1 plus a. Then let me close the bracket. So now here AB, then here a minus 1 whole plus. Okay, sorry, I'll just wrap this one. If I open the bracket, then I have to multiply this positive sign and negative sign. So plus into minus, minus. So I'll be writing here c square. Now let me just extend the position. This a let me write first. So plus a means, okay, I can just write here a, and minus 1 letter. So I'm going to write in this way. So remaining will be a minus 1. Okay, now I'll be taking a minus 1 common, then remaining is here ab and here minus c square. Now we have done the factorization and we'll be moving to the next question, question e. Here this is mb plus np plus mq plus nq. Okay, you please look at the expression properly. From the first two terms, I find here p common. If I take p common, then I'll get m plus n whole. Even from the last two terms, if you take q common, then you'll be getting m plus n whole. So now let me start taking common here. Here p, then we'll be getting here m plus n. Then plus, even from the last two terms, we'll be taking q common, so that we have m plus n. So in the next step, we're going to take this m plus n common. So m plus n common, then remaining will be here p, then here plus q. Okay, we'll be moving to the next question. That is question F. That is a square b plus 1 plus ab plus a. We have this expression. Now the first one and the third one, let me make a group. So a square b, and this is plus ab, so I'll write here plus ab. So the next will be, okay, please have a look at here. If you take ab common from these two terms, I'm sure that you'll be getting here a plus 1. So here we have plus 1 and plus a, so nothing wrong. I can write here plus a first and plus 1 later. So that from these two we'll be taking ab common, so that we have here a plus 1. So from these two, what is actually common here? 1 is the only common factor, so we can just write here a plus 1. Please have a look, it's a very important point here. There is important point. When I do not write any number here, you should always know that there is always 1. There is 1. So if I take here a plus 1 whole common factor, then here we'll get a b. Then if you just stop like this, then your answer will be wrong. So a b, then here plus, then don't forget there will be what? There will be 1. So 1 I'll write. Okay, we'll be moving to the next question. This is p q minus p minus q plus p square. Let's see properly. From the first two, what I find here is p q minus p, so I can take p common. Please have a look properly. I have made a group consisting of the first and the second term. So the remaining is minus q plus p square. From these two, I do not find any common factor. So I think this grouping, we do not get any, you don't get any use here. There's no benefit, there's no point of making in this group, in this way of grouping. So if I make the first and the third, let's see what do we get. Let me repeat. If I make the group of the first and the third, I'm sure you will be getting here q common and p minus 1. So remaining will be minus p plus p square. So minus p plus p square. So what do you get here? You can take here p common, so that minus 1 plus p. So minus 1 plus p means nothing wrong, you can write here p minus 1. Okay, so the right grouping will be first and the third, second and the last. So please have a look at here. When I write here minus p at the first, I'm getting here minus 1 here. So if I write in this way p square minus p, I'm sure you'll be getting this way directly. So here pq, here minus q. Next will be, let me write this positive first, plus p square, then minus p. So next we have q common, then p minus 1. So from the last two terms, p is a common factor, so let me take common here, then here p minus 1. So we have p minus 1 whole, and then q plus p. Now we have done this question. So we have next, this is the last question for the day. That is question n. That is x, then here x minus z plus y, then here minus yz. Okay, so this is a monomial and this is a trinomial. So let me multiply these terms one by one. X into x, x square. X into minus z, we'll get here x, z. The next, x into plus y, it will be plus x, y. Then we have minus y, z. Okay, so now let's see. It is just like the previous questions again. So if I take x common from the first two terms, let me repeat. If I take x common from the first two terms, we'll be getting in this way x minus z, like this. And from the last two, if you take y common, then I'm sure that you'll be getting y minus z. So it will be a right grouping for all of us. So I'll be taking the common factor now. From the first two terms, we'll take x common, so that x minus z. And from the last two, I can take here y common, so that we'll be getting here x minus z. So x minus z, I can take common, so remaining will be x plus y. Students, I believe and I hope that you would be learning something today. And thank you so much for watching once again. And we'll be meeting again very soon. Thank you.